I'm Doug Ray out at Falmouth, the Hoyt Cinema, where all these people are lined up to get tickets to a movie that hasn't even been released yet. We'll tell you why they say it's all worth it. Stay with us.
Star Wars Episode 1, The Phantom Menace, has not yet opened, but is coming soon to a theater near you.
In the neighborhood of Mount Washington, at the intersection between Virginia Avenue and Shiloh Street, next to Engine Company Number 27, sits a vending machine. Though this is no ordinary vending machine, for it holds an advertisement. An ad for a movie, Star Wars, Episode 1, The Phantom Menace. As such, this vending machine is a time capsule, preserving a lost sense of hope at the cusp of a new millennium. A crossfire of the old guard and the new. Hype and disappointment. Death and rebirth. Star Wars and Pepsi.
It's a normal vending machine. You approach the vending machine. You insert money into the vending machine. You choose your soft beverage from the vending machine. And the vending machine gives you your beverage. It's really no different from any other vending machine. What makes it different?
Well, some folks are calling it the most anticipated motion picture of all time.
The Phantom Menace.
The Phantom Menace.
The Phantom Menace.
Star Wars Episode 1, The Phantom Menace.
Star Wars.
Star Wars.
Star Wars, the prequel.
The Phantom Menace.
Star Wars Episode 1, The Phantom Menace.
Strictly calling the lead up to The Phantom Menace hype for a movie would be kind of underselling it. It was hype for a cultural moment, and for good reason. It had been 16 years since the last Star Wars movie had come out. 16 years. The generation that grew up watching those original Star Wars movies was filled to the brim with nostalgia and money. And at the same time, an entirely new, younger generation had just fallen in love with the franchise through VHS tapes, a best-selling book series, and the theatrical re-releases of the original trilogy in 1997. George Lucas and his team couldn't have manufactured a more perfect storm of hype if they tried. But they did.
The Phantom Menace is a dream come true for creator George Lucas.
And I can paint the way I was originally seeing things, and I like that.
The mass merchandising for this movie is almost unheard of.
Action figures to toothbrushes to comforters.
And I have the Darth Maul toothbrush.
In less than 10 minutes, the shelves were bare.
And the least popular toy, the pathetic middle-aged Star Wars fan action figure.
Trailer 1 was downloaded 10 million times. Not watched, downloaded. And the second trailer was downloaded 30 million times. People went to go see movies like The Waterboy and Meet Joe Black just to watch the trailer in theaters, and then they just leave. Pepsi spent $2 billion, billion with a B, on their promotional tie-in with the prequels, complete with custom Pepsi cans, even their own custom alien creature guy.
This is the weirdest date I've ever been on.
In this awesome promotion, KFC, Taco Bell, and Pizza Hut will each recreate one of the three planets in the Star Wars universe.
Taco Bell was Tatooine, Pizza Hut was Coruscant, KFC was Naboo, and they did all these crazy cross-promotional tie-ins with the Taco Bell dog and a Pizza Hut pizza delivery person, and Colonel Sanders with lightsabers fighting droids in Naboo.
I'm just ready to see the new movie, and that's my point of existence.
I've always wanted to be in the Star Wars movie. I'm kind of a freak in that way. So I had to be here just on a pilgrimage, you know, for Star Wars.
The fans were the real folks who put the work in. Fan sites ran wild with theories and leaks and news about the new movie. They sat outside toy stores for hours and outside movie theaters for weeks. Weeks.
You've been in line for 6 weeks, so you've been rotating in shifts, right?
Yeah, we take shifts.
People camped outside in line for weeks just to get tickets to this damn thing. All of this to say, there was a lot of hype, and a lot of money, and a lot of emotion riding on this movie. And it all turned out well when the movie premiered, and everyone loved it.
While fans square off on the lawn, 17-year-olds glaze the chops on the grill.
We give it to our brethren. We have spent over $200 on nothing but food.
Now this guy, believe it or not, has gone since last summer without seeing any image, any trailer, no music, no article, no review of the film. I know it's an incredible feat, but this guy did it. He saw any image for the first time last night at 12:01.
And what do you think?
And my thoughts?
Nothing can compare to this film.
It was amazing. It was everything I thought it was going to be and more.
I'd give it a definite thumbs up.
I think it was an excellent movie.
Thumbs way down.
Star Wars The Phantom Menace was the most...
Alright, I've stalled for long enough. I gotta actually watch this movie at some point. But I don't have any way of doing that. Looking for something? Here goes nothing. Anything else, The Phantom Menace is just boring. I mean, there's some standout scenes in there, don't get me wrong, and some great costumes and sets, and, you know,
I literally have nothing to say about this movie. Anything interesting left to think about with The Phantom Menace can really be encapsulated in this collector's edition widescreen VHS box. I mean, look at this box. The whole thing is falling apart. It feels emblematic of the brazen mass marketing for The Phantom Menace as a whole. Anything and everything would be commodified. The box comes with this collectible card that holds 5 frames from a 35mm theatrical print of The Phantom Menace. Its sequel, Attack of the Clones, would be the first movie entirely shot on digital. This leaves The Phantom Menace frozen in its growing pains between the analog techniques of the past and the foreboding digital revolution. This book holds concept art from the production of the movie. Doug Chang and his art team were given the Herculean task of bringing a universe of ideas from one dude's head into the real world, and I don't know how they could have done better. These folks made some real incredible designs and are ultimately responsible for the strongest parts of The Phantom Menace. Before the movie even starts on the VHS tape, there's this 15-minute documentary on the making of the movie. Now, today there's like 10 trillion documentaries from the production of The Phantom Menace, with an unprecedented level of access to the thought process of Lucas and his team. There's footage from 1994 of George going into his office and opening a fresh notepad to start writing his script. There's footage of 8-year-old Jake Lloyd signing his life away to be cast as Anakin, his team clapping behind him, blissfully unaware of the nightmare of death threats and bullying that would follow this movie's release for him. There's footage of Ewan McGregor choosing his lightsaber and a million lines from George Lucas that age like milk.
You can't destroy these things, you know. Jar Jar is a key to all this.
None of that's in this VHS, though. In here, it's all production and technology. These guys were really making up the rules of digital filmmaking as they went along, and it shows. The hundreds and hundreds of man-hours filled with blood, sweat, and tears behind the making of this movie can really be felt. Animators, actors, production designers, this movie was made on such an intergalactic scale, you almost forget that this movie is supposed to be about a vending machine.
Engine 27 has been stocking the pop machine themselves and using the proceeds to fix things up around the fire station. Star Wars fans from galaxies near and far, far away are known to make pilgrimages for selfies, of course. And don't worry, Podracers, because firefighter Paul Reiser tells us that the pop machine is not going anywhere.
I like it, it's cool. We've talked about like getting a new one and kind of re-upping it, because a lot of times this thing breaks down. For a while it's just taking quarters, but there's always such a following around it. We kind of try to keep fixing it and make it usable because the community likes it, people like it, so who are we to change it?
I got so swept up in the story of The Phantom Menace, I forgot why I was here in the first place, to talk about a vending machine. But the machine is more than emblematic of this one movie, it's emblematic of Star Wars as a whole. Because Star Wars has always been a vending machine. Since 1977, the deal behind Star Wars has been, you put some money into it, and you get a product out. Movies, toys, shows, cup toppers, whatever. But that's not inherently a bad thing. The heart of Star Wars was never in Fox, or Lucasfilm, or Pepsi, or Disney, or any other mega corporation. It's also not found in the people who call themselves fans but send death threats and spread toxicity. The heart has always been in the people, the ones who have brought this world to life, and the ones who find value in it.
And then we heard Episode 1 was going to come out. And for some reason, it all brought back those 22 years as if it had just happened last week.
Star Wars as a whole is an idea that is much, much, much bigger than even the biggest company in the world could yield. It's an idea that has manifested itself into millions of iterations, built off the blood, sweat, and tears of an unfathomable number of people. Directors, actors, cinematographers, writers, artists, producers, set designers, animators, programmers, VFX artists, sound designers, illustrators, book publishers, costume designers, background extras, production assistants, prop masters, stop motion animators, animatronics engineers, blog writers, action figure makers, picture book writers, moms who whip up cursed costumes 2 hours before trick-or-treating, voice actors, magazine interns, engineers, Target and Walmart stalkers, Lego builders, Taco Bell, KFC, Pizza Hut employees, Toys R Us midnight workers, movie theater popcorn poppers, Chewbacca impressionists, Yoda impressionists, Darth Vader impressionists, why the hell does everyone do impressions, projectionists, folks who know every word of the movie like it's scripture, and folks whose only knowledge of Star Wars is hello there, folks like the Firefighters Engine Company 27, with some junky soda machine held level by a couple 2x4s, folks that are able to turn the most mundane and trivial objects into cultural landmarks people drive hundreds of miles to find. That influence can't be found in a boardroom meeting, it's found in you and me. Maybe it's time we stop wasting our energy on yelling about everything wrong with Star Wars and appreciate it for the memories, stories, and real interactions it's been able to foster. Or maybe we can just shut up, drink some Pepsi, and laugh at this strange mess of a thing we all call Star Wars.
What's next for Star Wars fans? Episode 2 is now just 1,095 days away. Believe me, we won't do this to you. Nancy.